Right, okay, welcome back to the channel. Today, as you can see, we have a Sega Game Gear which doesn't do anything. So, I'm going to unplug that from the wall. I'm going to keep this little bit of plastic down. I'm just going to pop this rather cool little thing out. I've never seen one of them before, but I like it. And I'm going to get this apart. He says, looking for a different toolkit. Ah, humbug. I thought I had all the tools prepped and ready to go. Obviously not. But never mind. Now I have. So, we'll start by unscrewing this game bit screw at the top. And then the rest are just normal Phillips head screws. Somewhere over here there's a Phillips screwdriver, and we've got six screws. It's quite a nice looking unit, this one. It came to me yesterday from a friend who had picked up a load of old stuff and just said, do I want it? So I gave him 20 quid for this, a Saturn, and something which I had hoped I needed to fix but didn't actually need to do anything with. It's an old Invaders handheld game. In fact, I just lean over and grab that. It's one of these, and it works fine. Although, obviously, I'm not very good at it whilst on camera. So, let's carry on trying to strip this down. First of all, I want to attack the power board because obviously it's not powering on. Once we've rectified the power issue, then we can look and see if it makes a sound, and then look to see if we can get a picture. Obviously these are well known for having capacitors that fail. So we'll have the power board out and we'll replace some caps on that. I of course do not have a cap kit for this. I have a box full of capacitors and I'm just going to use some nearby reasonable looking ones because I like to do that. Up there is one screw left. Fixing a Game Gear on a budget. Right, you can. I think the cap kits are about £5 or £6, but I paid £7 or £8 for that whole box of caps. There's like 500 in there. So yeah, here we are. Our power board is this one over here. So disconnect that. Still keep meaning to tidy up this desk, still haven't done it. There we go, that should allow me to remove this. Let's just lift this pain in the arse thing up. So let's get this inspected. Yeah, you can go over there, mate. But that looks really nice and clean. They don't appear to be bulging of any types, but hey ho, let me go and check what ones need to come off, and I'm just going to pull them off and find things to replace them with. I'll be back. Okay, done a little digging. I know what I kind of need. I'm going to replace this one and this one first. This little bugger is like 6.3 volts, 820 microfarads. The nearest I have is 16 volts, 330, so that's probably not going to do it. So, let's have a look on the back. Let's get the flux out. Or what likes to pretend to be flux. Bit of new solder. So that should melt it off a little bit. And I can bring in my trusty one of these. As much of that out as possible, and then I'll just hold on to it. And yep, that's out. Then we'll do the same to the one down here, this one here. Can I just dump some solder on instead without the use of flux? Who knows? Probably. Okay, let's give it a little bit more heat. There you go. That one's out as well. So, C5. Our next chum is this one. Fatigue those off. Excellent. Now, just because I don't really want to try and change that one, I'm going to try it. Switch in, so let's use anything. What can I use? Come on, there must be a screwdriver. No, that's not made any difference. Okay. How have you stuck back on? Oh, flipping cartridges in there. I suppose I can change that one round as well. I do want to try and keep this one because I'm not sure if they're any good or not, and if this ridiculously underpowered 330 is going to actually work. Well, let's clean that hole up a bit. Let's not. Let's just apply some heat whilst I poke it through. Instead. And then we'll see what happens. I am not cutting those legs off. Just going to plug it in. Keep that outside of the case. Cart in. Yeah, you can just go over there. This is my main issue. I do want to keep fingers fairly well out of the way of everything. No, it still does the same. If not a bit less. brief flash of interest and then off it goes. So let's move on from the power board to the main board. Let's remove you. All right. Let's not. Let's remove you from there and there. That can go out the way. And now I guess I'll have to take everything out of the box. And we'll, I don't know. You look pretty knackered. 100 at 6.3. Wonderful. Oh, that smells good. Good and fishy. That is the lovely smell of bad caps. Better. Right, let's find something that will fit there. 100 at 6.3. Well, it's going to be 100 at 16. So just going to take this capacitor and break the legs a little. Just twisting the legs off at the minute. Obviously, if you are going to recap a Game Gear, do it properly. Don't budget like I currently am. But I just want to see if we can get this to work with the bare minimum of expenditure. Probably should have had a little bit more legs on there, but never mind. It's just got to go like that for the time being. Now, as I'm mental, or intelligently challenged, whatever you want to call it. I am going to change a cap, turn it on. Change a cap, turn it on. I have seen something I don't really like. Yeah, that was sticking up quite a bit. So let's just try it one more time. Off. Still the same old tut. Let's find our next one. 22 at 63. Twenty-two. What's the next one? 4.7. Oh, I have got one of those left, so I'll go there. But 22 first. This is so annoying not having proper snips. Just to cut the legs off. Right, let's do the next one. Obviously, be really careful. You don't want to rip the pads off. And these are stuck down. it. Right, my legs are off this one. Let's make sure it's round the right way. Clean the tip of the iron a bit. And then we'll fold that one over. And see if it's doing anything. Right. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Off. Okay. Getting a little bit more life. But not enough. Let's continue. So, where to next? Let's try one of these 68. Yeah, that's not coming off so easily. I should really, really unplug that power. There we go, that's better. So 68 at 6.3 volts. Well, we're not going to get much out of that. Let's go for 100 at 25. You absolute pleb. So we'll try and get some more of this icky stuff off. That does stink rather nastily. Obviously, all of that fish crap needs to be cleaned off properly should this get going. But first of all, I just want to see if it will work. Because obviously it is just what is known in the trade as a bodge. So let's have you there. Okay, so let's take the other one off. Oh yeah, that's just very wobbly. Well, that's really not happening. Let's chuck a load of this on there. Right, that's my alarm. I need to go out now, but this one needs to be done first. So, legs off of another one. Get some fresh solder. Now I've cleaned the tip a little bit, so clean it a little bit more. And then positive this way again. Let's get the negative on first. And now that's on, let's have a quick try again before I go and toddle off for a bit, and then I'll be back to carry on. So, power lead plugged in. How are we doing so far? Nope, still off and on, but well, that's all she wrote for the time being. I'll be back in a bit to carry on. Time to get back to it. So, where were we? We were here because this one looks a bit mangled, don't you think? So, that's a 33, 6.3 watt. Let's have that one off. If you wonder what I was up to in the brief seconds, but what was an hour for me, I went for a nice walk. Because I do like to get a bit of exercise in. I spend all day sat at desks in the various jobs. So, yeah, I need to get my steps in for the day. And I would have been out for a bit longer, but it's just started to hoy it down with rain. So I'm back to this for a bit. So, yeah. Come up reasonably well. Let's put some fresh solder on. What I could do, thinking about it, is actually take a power board out of the working game gear just to check, really. on our work. But for now, let's have a look in the box for a 33 or near to a 33 microfarad cap. Well, the best I'm going to do is a 22. Like this seriously is the biggest blodge. I need to buy another box of these capacitors because I've done a few game gears. I've probably had that box for a year or two, and like I say, I've done a few and used all the ones that were properly good for it. So now I'm just literally making up as I go along. But this is more of a just to see if you can bodge it with nearbys and not quite. This machine will not be up for sale in this state. Oh dear, no. So what we're looking for, positive is that side, negative is this side. So oh dear, still suffering with this cold. There's that one there. What's this one here? 10 microfarads at 6. Whoa, that was a bit sketchy. That was almost a little bit too dangerous. But obviously, as you can see, they are stuck down as well as being soldered. So of that shit. If you're curious, the 19 console job lot, I started on the Switch and the new 3DS, as I mentioned in a previous video. The parts for the Switch have arrived now. I'm still waiting for the parts for the new 3DS. So that is progressing, that video. Clean the tip, a bit more solder, and then find something for it. Right, no tens, so we're going to go for a 22 here as well. Okay, so that one's fitted and folded over. And if we scoot over to this side now, I've removed 48 and 6. So I just need to get this junk off of it. And then we can have a couple more on there. And I'm very, very much thinking that then it will be time to swap out the power board. That one. Okay, so I'll go and find some bits to fit those. Sweet, let's what have we got? Positive that side, positive, negative, right, okay. Probably should have put some more solder on these first. Let's do that now. Just looking at this, there's quite a bit of what looks like corrosion on those chips there. So this may require more work than was initially thought. And then positive, let's get some more solder on this one as well before I do that. So, negative this side. Positive there. Might be my two worst connections though, but let's see what happens now. So let's give it some power. It's not going to work, is it? That would just be ridiculous. Yep, see, you can tell the light just went on and straight off. Okay, well, I'm going to unplug this, dismantle another Game Gear, which I happen to have here, and just for the record, as it were, let's just plug that in and there you go. we're working on there. So I'm going to get this apart, pull that board out and come back. So the other one's apart. Here we go. Now let's plug it into here. And this is the moment of truth. Does this one now work? I'll just flick the power on, stuff it. Get the cable. That's an oven. That does even less than the last one did. And yet it works in that one. Okay, let's investigate this chip up the top there then, shall we? Move this out the way for a bit. Get the, that ASIC down there, they all do look a little bit wonky. I mean, the screen could be knackered, it could be anything really, but nearly up to temperature. Let's see what we can do. Perhaps a clean tip and some more solder. It's not looking good. I'll have to clean it up. Let's find a cotton bud. In fact, I think what I'm going to do is take this out. Still as well. That's still gone up in his top corner. Idiot. Come on, out you get. And all I'm going to do now is heat the shit out of it. Right, heat gun's up to temperature. Can't find any tweezers because of course I can't. There's a pair next to the sunglasses for some bizarre reason. Let's get a bit of flux on all of that. You can come off out of the way, but right, hopefully I can now spin that round. And try and get a bit more solder on there. Chucked the Wii remote on the floor, but never mind. Yeah, it's looking quite a mess at the moment. But let's get some more flux on it. At this rate, I may have to actually just take the chip off. Try and clean everything up. Yep, that's what I'm going to do. Now, let's have a look under there, shall we? How messy are they? Quite. Obviously, that all needs a good clean up. The chip is absolutely mullered with stuff everywhere. If I clean the tip, get a bit of flux. That could be one. Does look rather chip's really hot, but the board's not too bad, so just try cleaning this. And where's the IPA? And that cotton bud. Thank you. what's it like with flux and solder now? Well, we've lost a pad. Fucking wonderful. I mean, that is for the outside here. I'm going to presume that's a ground, but got a feeling this is well beyond my capabilities. But then I did say that about something else recently, which you haven't seen yet, and somehow it turned out it wasn't. But this needs to be done at a later date, so I'm going to leave this for now and come back to it another day. Right, hello, it's another day. In fact, it's the next day. What I've done here is I've chucked some of this really awful solder paste on there and given it a bit of a good cleaning up with that. I've taken this chip and cleaned up all of the bridges I'd put on there. So I'm going to attempt to try and put it back on. Obviously there's a lot of this terrible solder flux paste, I don't know, awful shit, shall we call it, but whatever it is, it needs to go back on. And obviously I need to try and line this chip up. Get this right on top, because obviously we do have one pin missing just off the end there, but hopefully if I get this all lined up nicely, that horrible stuff should technically hold it in place and allow me to heat it up with the heat gun and get it soldered back down. So obviously this is heating up. Whilst that's heating up, I am going to go and change the disc in the CD cleaner, because I've got 8 million discs to clean. So that's heated up. obviously it's decided to have a life of its own. Maybe I should have used a slightly lower air speed. Let's I'm hoping that that is going to be enough sort of pressure on here. I'll probably need to go over these as well. But I'll be back in a sec. So we're in, but I am going to try and zoom in a bit with the world's grubbiest thing. Yeah, that's not working. I can sort of see it. They do actually look like they are soldered. Just going to spin it round a bit. Try to get us zoomed in a bit more. Oh shit! Perhaps a touch more solder on those. Let's see, can I? I suppose what I should do really is get the test machine out, also known as a multimeter, and just see what we've got. So, top one. Yep. Next one. Yeah. I'm going to say that they're all connected. So, besides finding that poxy one I took off yesterday, which was, where was it? It was here. And what positive was this side? Yep. So, positive that side. Probably burn my fingers off now trying to do this, but. There we go, that's on. Right, I don't hold out much hope, but some hope. So why not give it a go? I also can't remember which one of these plugs is the one for the Game Gear and which one's the one for the SNES. So, well, it does flick on, but it doesn't do anything. I might have to admit defeat on this poxy bloody thing. I mean, we are one solder point from that chip short, aren't we? Just under there. Right, that last leg needs to come to here, I think. But I'm gonna have to look at that later, because I'm off. See ya. Right, I think my mission now is to try and connect this here to wherever it goes. So let's get the cap back off again. Just got to wait for the soldering iron to heat up. Right, we're at full temp. Throw you off, and then let's try and find out where this goes. So obviously that is just a massive gap at the moment. Does it go to what's underneath it? I suppose I'll look at the other Game Gear. Well, if the other Game Gear is anything to go by, and excuse the blurriness whilst I quickly zoom into wherever it is, that one in the top corner, I know it's a single ASIC one, but they're both joined together. So I'm just going to put a blob of solder between them. This may or may not be a ridiculous idea. But let's try it. Out we zoom, there's the screen. No, we still get a brief flash and nothing. And let's just take that one out. Put the original one that I messed around with back in there. But I think this is going to be a no fix. The light comes on, but just for a brief second and then goes out. Can we see anything on that screen whilst it does? Where's the cartridge? I mean, it could be that the tube's gone. Or it could be anything, really. All I know is this is unfortunately a failure. So it was bound to happen eventually, but this is knackered. I'm going to take the case that this came in because it's really nice and transplant this one into it because this is quite battered up. And then, well, yeah, make a nice one out of the pair of them. But unfortunately, this is a no fix. So thanks for watching and hopefully I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Bye.